The topic is electrolysis. The process of decomposition of electrolyte into constituent elements is called electrolysis. For example, NaCl. It conducts electricity by the movement of Na plus Cl minus ions, so it is known as electrolyte. It is decomposed into elements Na and chlorine element will form Cl2 by passing EMF. That process is called electrolysis. Fused NaCl that is taken in electrolytic cell. Here we take NaCl. Fused NaCl. Electricity passed by using two metal rods. The metal rod which conduct electricity, it contains positive charge is called anode, negative charge is called cathode. The process of decomposition of electrolyte into constituent elements by passing electromotive force EMF is called electrolysis. For example, if we take fused NaCl, here we take fused NaCl. It contains ions Na plus and Cl minus ion. Suppose this one is anode, positive cathode. Negative ion Cl minus move towards anode and positive ion Na plus move towards the cathode. Anode reaction is 2Cl minus, it gives rise to Cl2 plus 2 electrons. It lost electrons means oxidation. At anode always oxidation takes place, at cathode always reduction takes place. 2Na plus 2 electrons, it gives rise to 2Na. Gain electrons reduction, that is takes place at the cathode. Here only one type cation, one type anion, these are present. If more than one type anion cations are present, then which ion is a discharges? Discharges means convert into element state. The which ion convert into element state? Discharged ion, that is depend on the discharge potential. That is explained by discharge potential theory. If more than one ions are present, the ion which has less discharge potential, that discharges first. Discharge potential of cations order. La plus greater than K plus Na plus greater than Ca plus 2 greater than Mg plus 2 greater than Al plus 3 greater than Zn plus 2 greater than H plus greater than Cu plus 2 greater than Hg plus 2 greater than Ag plus greater than Au plus 3. This one is discharge potential of cations order. Anion discharge potential order. Anions order is F minus greater than phosphate greater than sulfate greater than nitrate greater than OH minus greater than Cl minus greater than Br minus greater than I minus. This one is discharge potential of the anions. It is useful more than one ions are present. For example, if we take aqueous NaCl, aqueous NaCl on electrolysis, here we take aqueous NaCl, which on electrolysis by using electrodes. Now here ions present, aqueous means H plus OH minus, NaCl, Na plus Cl minus, anode and cathode. Anode is positive and cathode is negative. Here negative ions OH minus Cl minus 2 present, which has less discharge potential Cl minus. So Cl minus discharges first. So 2Cl minus, it gives rise to Cl2 plus 2 electrons. This reaction takes place. Cathode, negative 2 positive ions are present, H plus Na plus, which has less discharge potential. H plus has less discharge potential. So H plus discharges first. 2H plus plus 2 electrons gives rise to H2. Here also oxidation reaction takes place at anode and reduction reaction takes place at the cathode. If we take fused NaCl, sodium formed at cathode, chlorine liberated at the anode. If we take aqueous NaCl, chlorine liberated at anode and hydrogen is liberated at the cathode. Products are changed. Here product formed, that is explained by discharge potential theory. When we discuss electrolysis, it is explained by two laws, Faraday first law and Faraday second law. First, Faraday first law. Let this one is electrolytic cell. Which on electrolysis, the Faraday first law statement is, here let this one is anode cathode, here mass of the substance deposited or dissolved means mass of the cathode decreases, dissolved or gas, if gases are formed, liberated. Mass of the substance dissolved or deposited or liberated, like that one is M, is directly proportional to quantity of electricity passed through the electrolyte in coulombs. M proportional to Q, where Q current in coulomb, Q that is equal to C into T, C current in ampere, T time in second. Current in coulomb, that is equal to product of current in ampere and time in second. M, that is equal to, we can write small e into Q, where small e is the proportionality constant. Its value is equal to mass deposited while 1 coulomb electricity is passed. Suppose here we take Q value 1, small e, that is equal to M. Here small e is known as electrochemical equivalent. Small e definition is mass deposited when 1 coulomb electricity is passed is known as electrochemical equivalent. 1 coulomb deposited mass small e, if we take 1 Faraday, that is equal to 96,500 coulomb, then deposited mass nearly equal to is equal to capital E, where capital E is called chemical equivalent. The relation is small e, that is equal to capital E by 96,500. So we can substitute in this relation. M, that is equal to E, in place of Q you can write C T by 96,500. This E value is equal to chemical equivalent, that is equal to atomic mass by atomic mass of element by valency. That means M by Z. So in place of E we can write M by Z. It is known as Faraday first law. Next, Faraday second law. Faraday second law statement. In Faraday second law, different electrolytic cells which are connected in series, these are the different electrolytic cells. Suppose here we take electrolyte aqueous H2SO4, here we take aqueous CuSO4 and aqueous AgNO3. Three different electrolytes are taken and these are connected in series. Suppose this one is anode, cathode, anode, this one is anode, cathode. One electrolyte cathode connected to next one anode, next one anode. This type of arrangement is known as series. Here anode, this one is connected to the battery. Suppose here Q amount of current is passed through the electrolytes connected in series. When same quantity of electricity passes through different electrolytes connected in series, then mass of the substance deposited at respective electrolytes is directly proportional to their chemical equivalents. That means in first electrolytic cell, mass of hydrogen liberated, that is directly proportional to chemical equivalent EH2. Here mass of the copper deposited directly proportional to equivalent weight of the copper. Mass of Ag proportional to equivalent weight of the Ag. That is statement of the Faraday second law. When same quantity of electricity passes through different electrolytes connected in series, then mass of the substance liberated or deposited, that is directly proportional to their chemical equivalents. We can write ratio MH2 by MCU, that is equal to EH2 by ECU. Ratio of mass deposited, that is equal to ratio of their chemical equivalents, we can say.